Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome to the beauty of live radio. So we are having some technical difficulties this morning. You probably could tell that. It's always fun doing remote broadcasts when you never know what you're going to find, but we are here, and you are listening to Ron Siegel Radio. This is the show with no real boundaries as we discuss current events, financial markets, politics, sports, even poking fun at the rest of the media. This is the show that connects the dots of confusion, and there's a lot of confusion this morning. We connect the dots of confusion so you know how your family, your business can benefit from current events. Most of all, thank you for joining me. Before we get into our intriguing content today, please join me in welcoming our featured guest. Rick Muro's in the house from Gold Star Mortgage. Welcome.
Good morning.
Glad to have you with us. And let me remind you, if you ever have any home or finance-related questions, I am the consumer advocate looking out for you. And you can reach out to me directly at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Just remember, that's the number you call anytime for assistance. When you call that number, it comes directly to me first. There are no operators standing by. I am it.
Quiet, numbskulls. I'm broadcasting.
While I do have a great team when it comes to developing a financing plan or plan to save you money, I personally work with you. Even if you don't have any needs today, save this number in your phone for future reference, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. And yes, of course, we are having some fun today. It is National Deep Dish Pizza Day today. And having beaten anorexia, I will be celebrating. We might do a little more than just deep dish pizza after the broadcast today, being that we are having so much fun and the technical challenges that we are experiencing today. Take a look at what the markets are doing as well. That's a little bit of fun this morning as well, having the markets, the Dow Jones Industrial Average up 139 points. We're also looking at oil up 18 cents per barrel. And if my computer would stop going to this dumb other site, so we can see that the 10-year Treasury, 2.358 is where we're at on the 10-year Treasury right now. I'm going to talk about a lot of great stuff on the broadcast this morning. We are looking at a very interesting set of circumstances. Obviously, the world news is a little bit fun right now, watching what's going on with Susan Rice.
So I know who's ass to kick.
You know, she would have had a problem with one of the recent movies that we broadcast or chat about on a regular basis on Ron Siegel Radio. You see, I don't think Jack Nicholson would have liked her.
I want the truth! You can't handle the truth!
Yeah, well, I don't think she understands the truth, so that's part of her problem as it is, but just amazing the way some people are. And we keep going back to her. We are looking also at California being a sanctuary state. Have you seen any of the articles about what's going on at the state? It's, I think the number is AB54 is the number that they're using for this bill up there in Sacramento. Kind of crazy that what they're talking about there, because it basically allows for anybody who wants to do anything in California, you can get away with it. Now, we already know the governor has opened the doors to all of the jails. That's just been a given that the governor has done that kind of stuff. But now they're looking at it if you've murder, rape, child molestation, all those things are basically fair game in the state of confusion. And if the whole thought there is, it all has to do with immigration. They don't want to support what the president is doing. Unbelievable, and they're getting away with it. So just a little bit of fun there. I mean, we have had some technical problems this morning. We're going to do an abbreviated opening monologue. That's about as abbreviated as it gets, because I know Robert Mott is on the line with us. And I could use a glass of wine right about now. So Robert and I will be chatting about wine. And then we're going to talk a little bit today. We've got some very interesting commentary because of what goes on in the marketplace. One of the fun things about doing a live radio show or a daily radio show, I get the opportunity of chatting with a lot of people, consulting with a lot of people. And every once in a while, we see issues where people make a bad decision and it costs them. And unfortunately, it might cost them either a lot of money, might cost them the house of their dreams, might cost them some of their reputation. So we're going to talk about lending and why you need to pick a great lender as well as a great real estate professional. So we're going to get into that this morning as well. Remember, you can reach us anytime. Our off-air number, 800-306-1990. 800-306-1990 or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio, on Twitter @ronsiegel. Stay tuned. We will be back in just a few.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert, Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That's my message. And as your consumer advocate, I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. The Mortgage Minute today being brought to you by the area trusted real estate professionals of Ron Siegel Radio. Text NEST, N-E-S-T, to 79564. One of the real estate professionals will get you set up on a home search so you can find your dream home before somebody else does. Just put in your parameters right there and they will get all that information off to you. What is a no-doc loan? That is our subject this morning. It's kind of a misnomer. It can be somewhat misleading to people because there really is no such thing as a no-doc loan. Because you have to have some sort of documents. How do you record the deed? How do you record the lien? So it's not really a no-doc loan. What it really means is there are alternative ways of documenting income so that for those people that are commission-based or they're business owners or they've got other methods, they can still get a loan, but there's just lighter documentation on it. So they might use bank statements. They might use an asset depletion model if you've got a large trust account that can be used along those lines. A lot of different options in there, but it's really not a no-doc loan. It's just really, they should really title it just light doc loan would probably be more accurate or more appropriate for the product itself. That is the Mortgage Minute, again, brought to you by our friends at NEST, N-E-S-T, text NEST, N-E-S-T, to 79564, and get on that home search, find your dream home before somebody else does. Red, red wine means it is time for our Wednesday morning chat, I hope, with Robert Mott. We are having some technical difficulties, so we're just going to go blind here. Robert, are you with us? Can you hear me now? Well, let's try one other thing here. We might have to try Robert Mott, and we're going to try something a little bit more fun with Robert Mott. This is something a little bit new for us as well. But let's see if we can try Robert Mott this way. We're going to give me just 1 second here, if you would, my friends over at the station. And let's see if we can get Robert Mott tied into us through the old-fashioned version of telephone systems. Let's see if I can get him on here through this. See if Robert Mott will hear me checking in with him right now.
Hey, this is Rob.
Is this Robert Mott? Hello? Can you hear me now?
I can hear you now, Ron.
Holy cow, we might have Robert Mott on technology. We're going back to the old school technology, Robert. So hopefully our audience is hearing everything that we're hearing right here, but this might be a one for the ages for us to try and deal with.
A private conversation with two cans and a long string, right?
There you go. You know something, sometimes the old school ways are the best ways, but we're going to see if we can figure this one out this morning. So let's see. I know we had some notes here about talking about savings or storing red wine. So being that we're doing this, there might not be any red wine for me to store at the end of this broadcast, but tell me about those pump things.
I can certainly empathize with your technical difficulties, Ron. Sometimes the best laid plans, you know, no matter how technically savvy we all are, this nothing works. But anyway, yeah. So, you know, a question came up. I saw this in an article the other day. How long will a red wine last if I use one of those vacuum pump things to remove the air from the bottle? and seal it with that rubber stopper. You've probably seen those things that look like a little T-handle, a little gray stopper, rubber stopper you stick in the wine bottle and you pump it out, pump the air out.
I feel kind of foolish when I'm doing that.
Yeah, it looks kind of foolish too. And you know, I've seen some restaurants use those as well, and I was always kind of dubious, you know, about the effectiveness of that. And I actually saw an article the other day on this, and it mimicked almost exactly what I thought about the whole process. So certainly mixed feelings about these vacuum pumps and stoppers. You know, I've used them myself, and historically I have anyway. It kind of feels like you're doing something proactive, like you were doing something to really help the wine last. And obviously there's that satisfying pop when you pull the stopper out. But since then, I've read a lot of experiments by people who, you know, spend their time, you know, during the day experimenting stuff exactly like this, and comparison tastings using these stoppers. And the results are wholly inconclusive, I would say. it seems widely accepted that while there might be some, it might form a good seal when you put that rubber stopper in and remove some of the air because of that kind of natural pressure differential. You know, the air outside is trying to get in, so it's kind of pushing the stopper more firmly in place. But it doesn't remove all the oxygen, and these stoppers almost always leak to some extent. So you still have oxidation going on. And there's also some concerns that people have brought up about, since you're pulling the air out that's above the wine and the ullage there, that empty space, you're also taking some of the aromatics out of the wine when you pump the air out, resulting in wines that could end up tasting a little bit flat the next day, not quite as alive. Of course, you know, most wines will taste relatively flat after being open for a day, so, you know, who's to say it's any better as before, but that kind of goes to the speaks to the heart of this kind of mixed feelings or kind of inconclusive nature of if this if using this technology actually helps or not. But you know, we've talked about this before. Once you open a bottle of wine, no matter what method you use to preserve it, you probably won't get more than 2 or 3 days of extra life from it, more or less, depending on the wine, how sensitive you are to the particular flavors in the wine, and all those kinds of things, and you know, of course, how you choose to store it. But there are some things that you can always do, whether you use those vacuum stoppers or not, to give leftover wine a little extra life. Put it in the refrigerator, both reds and whites. If you're not using the little pump, if you use an inert gas like an argon or something like that, you see those little. I think the brand I always see is that those cans of gas that they always feel like they're empty, or it's called wine preserver or something like that. So, you know, put a layer of inert gas on top of the wine. Or transferring, the other method some people use is transferring the wine to smaller bottles that doesn't have that much airspace on top to kind of limit that that surface area for oxygen exposure. So, you know, I think the fundamental thing is you can either invest in the thing that pulls some of the air out and kind of creates a little bit of a vacuum, or you can kind of do those things we talked about limiting the temperature and keeping it tightly sealed and, you know, just basically limiting the amount of oxygen content to contact with the wine. So, you know, it might make you feel better. And if you like those things and you believe in them, by all means, go ahead and use them. But if you're one of the inquiring minds like me, maybe you want to put a question whether or not it's really worth the effort or not.
A little bit of a placebo effect, it sounds like.
Exactly.
So what's your thoughts about the anymore? I mean, I know you and I had talked about this ages ago, but what are the thoughts? Or anything new on the Coravin systems?
Well, you know, they continue to evolve. I was one of the early adopters of the Coravin system, and certainly I'm a big believer in that because I've actually kept wine for over a month and really have not noticed a tremendous amount of degradation using that. And for those of people who are unfamiliar with the Coravin system, basically it's a thing that basically has a little gas capsule. I think it's an inert gas like an argon or something like that. It has a needle that actually penetrates the cork. So this works on wines that have a cork closure. Obviously, it doesn't work on the ones with the screw top or the glass enclosure. But, you know, the needle penetrates the cork. You hold down a little trigger. It pumps a little argon in there. Gives a little pressure to the wine. You tip it over, and you can pour wine through this needle that penetrates the cork. And... when you're finished pouring the wine, you pull the needle out and remove the device, the cork end device. And the cork, being resilient, it naturally seals behind the needle. So it actually provides a, continues to provide something very similar to the original seal that that came from the winery. And then the inert gas that you pumped in there, obviously, is there to displace any oxygen that might get in there as well. But I've actually experimented with this system with some old, what I would call old and fragile wines, maybe some 1980 Sonoma Cabernets, and I was actually able to taste them over over a number of weeks, and really did not notice any flavor degradation or flatness really show up into the bottle until probably the fourth week, or when I was well below half the volume remaining in the bottle. So, yeah, like I say, a big believer in Corvin as a system for those people that want to invest in a little more sophisticated way to preserve their wine. Or they are people who rarely ever are able to finish a bottle of wine at one sitting. Obviously, Ron, that's not necessarily the problem that you and I always have.
Exactly.
But the technology continues to progress. They have some new models out that are becoming easier to use, and I think I'm still a big advocate of using that that cork and wine extraction system. And I think you'll see it. You continue to see it more prevalently in some of the local restaurants as well. It gives those restaurants the ability to actually pour some really, really very pricey, high-end exclusive wines without running the risk of excessive spoilage by having to toss out that wine or drink it yourself, of course. But, that's not what your business you're in when you're in the restaurant business. So, anyway, you start to see a lot more of these things showing up. And for anybody has, I think they're about, today they're between, somewhere between $200 and $300. I don't know what the current price is.
I'm looking at it on Amazon right now at $299.
$2.99. There you go. So if you get a chance and you have $300 burning a hole in your pocket, and you're a wine geek like maybe some of us on the show, it might be a worthwhile investment for you.
Good stuff as always, Robert Mott. Thanks for joining us on this technologically challenged Wine Wednesday. Always good information. You are listening to Ron Siegel Radio, discussing your real estate current events and the financial markets. When we come back, selecting a great lender is just as important as selecting a great real estate professional. We're going to chat about that. Buying this spring, be prepared for bidding wars, and five things millennials need to know about retirement. Remember, you can reach us anytime. Our off-air number, 800-306-1990. 800-306-1990 or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio, on Twitter at Ron Siegel. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Where's she from?
Lending team offers you buying power. That's saying you can afford a monthly mortgage payment, including principal and interest, of around $1,900. With today's rate on a 30-year fixed mortgage of 3.75%, APR 3.85%, that payment could support a 400. Is roughly the average home mortgage rate over the past 30 years. That same $1,900 mortgage payment, including principal and interest, may only be able to support a $314,000 mortgage. That's over $100,000 worth of home you're missing out on by waiting. That's buying power. All you need to do to get started is reach out to the Siegel Lending Team at 800-306-1990. That's 800-306-1990. Or visit SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L LendingTeam.com. Payment example excludes taxes and insurance. Call us for full details, 800-306-1990. That's 800-306-1990 or SiegelLendingTeam.com. Equal housing lender, licensed under NMLS number 217037. Is your credit score over 800? Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? Are you earning a safe, secure 10%+ return on your investments? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey, and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Are you purchasing or own a luxury home? If you're like so many others, your home is your largest asset and the mortgage is your largest debt. The Siegel Lending Team has some amazing financing opportunities right now. Jumbo loans up to $2 million, 30-year rates below 4%, 15-year rates near 3.5%, and if you can believe it, 7-year interest-only hybrids in low threes. The Siegel Lending Team has all the options for your jumbo or second home loan requirements. Take advantage of them while you can. To learn more about all the other financing products available from the Siegel Lending Team, call 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L LendingTeam.com. Again, call 1-800-306-1990. Rates subject to change without notice. Licensed by NMLS ID 217037 and 145502. Equal housing lender.
Do you own real estate or have assets over $150,000? Do you know one of your heirs will be the probate court and the IRS? If you don't have a living trust, you will go through probate. Call Heritage Financial Services toll-free at 1-855-434-7400 for a free review. Check us out on Facebook, Heritage Financial Service in Lake Forest, California. That's 1-855-434-7400. Again, 1-855-434-7400.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert, Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That's my message, and as your consumer advocate, I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. The real-time real estate segment today being brought to you by our friends over at Gold Star Mortgage. When you're ready for a mortgage, any type of a mortgage, Gold Star has the programs for you. Buying this spring? Yeah, if you're looking at buying real estate this spring, you might want to be prepared for bidding wars. Traditionally, spring is the busiest season for real estate. Buyers come out in force and homeowners list their houses for sale, hoping to capitalize on buyer activity. This year will be no different. Buyers have already been out in force looking for their dream homes, and more are on their way. But the challenge is that the inventory of homes for sale has not kept up with demand, which has led to a lot of competition for the homes that are available. Recent Bloomberg article touched on the current market conditions, and I quote, "It's the 2017 U.S. spring home selling season, and listings are scarcer than they've ever been. Bidding wars common in perennially hot markets like the San Francisco Bay Area, Denver, and Boston are now also prevalent in the once slow and steady heartland, sending prices higher and sparking desperation among buyers across the country." Sam Cotter, the deputy chief economist at CoreLogic, went on to explain why buyers are flocking to the markets in big numbers. In today's market, I quote, "many buyers think that the trough in interest rates is over. If you don't get in now, it's just going to be worse later. Rates will be higher, prices will be higher, and maybe inventory selection will be lower. In some markets, 35% of properties are selling within the first week or two of hitting the market. Homes are selling at a rapid clip in places like Denver, Seattle. I have no clue why in Oakland. Maybe people just want to get out of them. Grand Rapids, Michigan, Boise, Idaho, Madison, Wisconsin, Omaha, Nebraska." And even though they don't put this in the national news, we know that it's happening right here in beautiful Southern California. If you want to talk about the market, give me a call, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. That's the real-time real estate segment brought to you by Gold Star Mortgage. And Gold Star actually has a program. I'm going to have Rick talk about that. Rick Muro is here. He's the branch manager locally from Gold Star. They've got a program that helps level the playing field. Actually, maybe even for some buyers, they can get an advantage in the marketplace. One of the things I'm seeing, Rick, I don't know if you're seeing this, and welcome, I should say, even.
Thank you. Good morning.
One of the things that I'm seeing in the marketplace is real estate agents, in order to get some sort of an advantage, rightly or wrongly, they're just decreasing the time of escrow. Are you seeing that as well?
No question. I mean, I think that any tactic they can do to speed up the time of the close is fair game.
Yeah, and I just saw a transaction yesterday where the buyers really weren't even qualified, but the agents and buyers and sellers all negotiated a 21-day escrow. And we're seeing that. I'm seeing that more and more. I don't know. Are you coming across that, and is there a solution to try and make that work?
Of course there is. With our program called the Fast Pass, it allows our buyers to get into underwriting and actually be fully approved when they go to make their offers.
We say fully approved. I mean, what does that really mean? Because a lot of people don't understand the whole loan process. They buy a house once every, you know, 5-7 years. Actually, now we're talking about 10-year hold period.
Well, typically what happens in the market is that somebody will identify a property they want to buy, and then they get under contract, and then they submit their loan. So then what we're doing is we're loaning on that particular property. Well, we kind of back that step up one pace, where we actually will get them ready and approve their loan without them actually identifying a property yet. So that means that they can go in and make an offer that's non-contingent, only contingent upon the title, And the appraisal itself.
Okay, so title and appraisals, and so they don't have to worry. They've already done all the issues. But one of the things, I mean, the one program I just saw was a lender actually apparently gave out. I mean, I don't know of any real good real estate professionals that are going to go shopping without some sort of a pre-approval letter.
In the last 3 or 4 years, we have never seen an offer being made without a pre-approval letter attached. Well, ours takes it that next step where it says they actually are approved.
Okay, so how would the consumer or how would a seller be able to identify that? What would they be looking for? I mean, is it going to say something? Is your pre-approval letter going to be different or identify this, or, you know, big flashing letters or something on there?
Well, the difference is pre as opposed to approved, where we actually specifically say this is a non-contingent offer on financing.
Okay.
And then it's marked that way on the residential purchase agreement.
I'm going to throw a scenario at you, because, and I'm not going to use any names because we want to protect the innocent. I saw a buyer out there in the marketplace, and they had we see this all the time. It was a divorce case, obviously, Southern California, 70% first-time marriages end divorce, nothing special there. They had a bankruptcy 3 years ago and a foreclosure 2 years ago. And they're out there shopping for an FHA loan. Right, and we know that those doesn't quite make the numbers.
You know, it never ceases to amaze me. After doing 1,500 loans in this industry in the last 15 years, I think I've seen it all. But that was we actually had this discussion in the office yesterday about that particular file, and nobody had ever seen this situation before. So it always is very, very important that you get with a good lender that can dissect what the problems are and any red flags. So in this particular case, it'll depend on whether or not the actual foreclosure came before the bankruptcy or the bankruptcy came before the foreclosure. So,
and I would assume that an experienced lender doing 1,500 loans probably take 10 minutes to figure out that you might have a problem on something like that? Would it take that long?
I hope not. If it takes 10 minutes, you're not doing your job.
Right. I mean,
you're not paying attention.
Right. I mean, it's basically you're going to see something like that as soon as you see a credit report. Cool. Now, one of the things that is also a little misleading that we see, and I know that the great lenders have to look at this also, is the credit report may not identify when the property was actually taken back, as opposed to just when the foreclosure started.
And that's when your title relationship comes into play there. So you can get with your good title rep to actually get that documentation for you to find out when it actually was foreclosed.
It's interesting that you bring it up in that manner, Rick, because I'm promoting all the time on radio that you have to have a great team.
Absolutely.
Right? I mean, so you want to have a great real estate partner, real estate professional, realtor, if that's the way they decide to go. You have to have a great lender. And now you're throwing in there that we need to have a relationship with a title company.
Absolutely.
Right? So it's a whole conglomerate.
Right. I mean, it's everything from your processor to your underwriters. They're all on the same team, making sure that they're moving the files forward and appropriately and getting things taken care of before, again, there are the 11th hour issues.
One of the things when we come back I want to chat about, number one, is how long does it really take once you go through the Gold Star process, how long is it going to take to get a loan finished once you identify the property? Because it sounds like a lot of work's done before that. So we want to talk about how long it's going to take, and then what are the risks of going out and making an offer without having some of these things done. So we want to chat with Rick Muro about that. Rick's from Gold Star Mortgage, and don't tell him he's the one that I always tell you that he's going to give away a bunch of money every week. So we'll talk about that when we come back. We might throw that at him when he's, you know, I usually do it when he's not listening, but I might do it this time when he's here as well. You can reach us anytime. Our off-air number, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. Connect with us, facebook.com/ronsiegelradio, on Twitter, @RonSiegel. And if you miss any part of our broadcast, Ron Siegel 1 on YouTube. Ron Siegel, the numeral 1 on YouTube. Stay tuned. We'll be back in just a few.
Are you living in the home of your dreams or simply where you think you can afford? Are you earning a safe, secure 10%+ return on your investment? Is your credit score over 800? If the answer to any of these questions is no, what are you doing about it? Text ATP to 79564. Complete a 3-minute complimentary survey, and the area trusted professionals of Ron Siegel Radio will reach out to you to develop a success strategy for you. Again, all you need to do is text ATP to 79564.
Isn't it time you found out the truth about FHA insured home equity conversion? No, it's not your grandfather's reverse mortgage. This just may be the finest financial planning strategy available for all homeowners of retirement age. Helping protect what you've earned is the job of your board of directors with continued education. Major research has shown that using a HECM will significantly enhance the success rate of a retiree's portfolio and legacy. Please allow us to educate. For your complimentary consultation, call Jay Kaplan at 949-300-3855. That's 949-300-3855.
Are you currently renting a home? Do you like paying someone else's mortgage payment? Why not explore the options to purchase your own home? Can you imagine a 30-year fixed-rate loan below 4.25% APR? This means with $10,500, you can purchase a $295,000 home and have a principal and interest payment of about $1,400 per month. What are you paying in rent? Does your family deserve the opportunity to take advantage of the current market? To learn more about these exciting opportunities, the Siegel Lending Team is standing by to speak with you. Call now, 1-800-306-1990. That's 1-800-306-1990. Or visit SiegelLendingTeam.com. That's S-I-E-G-E-L LendingTeam.com. Or 1-800-306-1990. Rate subject to change without notice. Licensed by NMLS ID 217037 and 145502. Equal housing lender. Not endorsed or sponsored by any government agency.
Do you have a goal of mortgage-free home ownership? What if your home was valued at $500,000? Are you aware that a free and clear home could be costing you $2,500 every month, $30,000 per year? The mortgage planners at the Siegel Lending Team would like to show you how you can own your home, generate tax-free income, and accumulate family wealth. You simply need to call the Ron Siegel Team at 1-800-306-1990. That is 1-800-306-1990. By sending the team a copy of your most recent mortgage statement, the team will send you a no-obligation real estate plan. You be the judge if this is right for your family. Again, all you have to do is send the team a copy of your mortgage statement by email to REAP at ronsiegelradio.com or call today, Ron Siegel, 1-800-306-1990. That is 1-800-306-1990.
Subject to change and without notice. Licensed by the California DOC and VRENMLS 217037 and 145502 and Cal VRE 01869452 and 186675.
You're listening to Ron Siegel's Home and Finance Show with local and national expert Ron Siegel. Now, here's Ron.
Welcome back to Ron Siegel Radio. Within every market, there are solutions as well as tremendous opportunities. You just need some trusted guidance. That's my message, and as your consumer advocate, I will be delivering it every day on Ron Siegel Radio or anytime at 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990. The Word on Wealth segment today being brought to you by AskAboutReverseMortgages.com. If you are 62 years of age or older, got equity in your property, the reverse mortgage might be the right solution for you. Education is always a valuable solution for you. Check out AskAboutReverseMortgages.com. Things millennials need to know about retirement. First off, max out employer matches. Now, you know that I believe the 401k is nothing more than a ruse to get more of your money. The only good part about the 401k is the employer match. If your employer's matching, take that. Anything else, say goodbye, say sayonara, say adios, because you don't want to pay more taxes than you have to. Consider a Roth IRA. Love the Roth IRA, especially to save money for other expenses. Remember this, if you put the difference between your $1,000 deductible mortgage or home insurance payment and the $2,500 deductible mortgage insurance or home insurance, hazard insurance payment into a Roth IRA, you're only going to have a claim once every 10 to 12 years are the statistics on that. Put the money in there. There is no, again, talk to your tax professional, but there's no tax liability to take your money out. It's the earnings that are growing tax-free. Choose volatile investments. When you're younger, you can take a little bit more risk, but you may want to just call Al Manfrey and get that safe, secure 8% every year and just say cha-ching, cha-ching all the time. If you can get 8% and not worry about losing money, now again, there's no guarantees, but we can say that for about 30 years, we've been seeing the same things. Get that safe, secure money. Make a plan. Talk to Al. He'll help you with that plan as well. And have some non-retirement savings. Also, your Roth IRA can help with that one if you use the strategy I just shared with you. That is the Word on Wealth segment, again, brought to you by AskAboutReverseMortgages.com. So we're chatting this morning. Rick Muro is with us, Gold Star Mortgage, and we've been chatting about the idea of having a great lending partner. It's amazing how few people spend the time to look for a great lender. Rick, you probably heard this a million times. They don't ask you how many loans you've done. People probably don't think about the concept that you've done 1,500 loans. They don't think about the experience level that you have. They don't think about how many files you're looking at every day. I hear this all the time. What's the interest rate? Right? And sometimes you can lose a whole lot of money by worrying about that eighth of a point. Right, by not getting great counsel on a long-term basis.
Well, and not only that, an eighth of a point most people don't realize on, say, a $300,000 loan means about $20 difference in a month. So are you willing to risk potential fall through of a loan or buying the wrong property and not having great consultation from a good lender for $20 a month?
So here's let's throw some numbers. I love that idea, Rick, because that's $20 a month. So we'll go back to the same case that we were talking about earlier. You have an individual that goes in and buys a $660,000 house. And I don't know all the numbers, right? So let's just say hypothetically they did 2% as a earnest money deposit. So roughly $12,000.
Right.
And went in there with a lender that said, okay, we can get this done for you. They probably gave them a pre-approval letter. And they've got a $12,000 at risk on a 21-day escrow. And 8 or 10 days in, they find out, yeah, we missed something. We can't do it.
Oh, you see it happen at that 20th day, and the lenders missed something. Now that they're at risk of losing that entire deposit, besides losing face with your realtor partner and everybody else. I mean, it's all about the customer experience. So in order to really protect yourself, you've got to have a professional that can look at your credit report, look at the property itself, look at your income, and all those individual items that go into a loan, and look for any potential snake bites right up front.
So think about this just from a numbers standpoint. I like to throw numbers out there, right? So you take that $12,000 that are at risk, and you're talking about saving maybe $20 a month. And I just did some math because I'm a simple guy. So it came out to 600 months worth of savings could be blown by making that kind of a mistake.
Without question. I mean, you see that happen, and you see it happen all the time, unfortunately. You know, where a lender is more of a yes man, where they're giving pre-approvals out like tickets to the fair.
And basically a pre-approval letter from some lenders, I don't say all of them because I don't know all of them, but some of them is nothing more than cut and paste in a Word document.
No question about that. They're really not pre-approving anything. That's really more of an overview. they've looked over and you've gotten some general information from a client, and that you say that they're pre-approved.
Might be like a prayer. Right, yeah. But and you know something, I share this with folks all the time. I have no problem with surprises, right? Birthdays, anniversaries, weddings. That's a good time for surprise. Graduation. We're coming up on graduation season.
I don't know about a wedding being a surprise. That may not be.
Well, the gift maybe. There might be some surprise you don't want there. Yeah, you might have. There, that's true. But the idea here is, when you're talking about buying a $600,000 house or taking on a $600,000 debt, I don't really think you want surprises.
Absolutely not. You've got to align yourself with a professional. Ask your realtor who they recommend. Look at Zillow or Yelp reviews. Do a little due diligence on the largest investment you're ever going to make.
Now, from the other side of the coin, now we look at this all the time as well because we know that we get a lot of professionals listening to Ron Siegel Radio. From the real estate person's standpoint, what do they look like when they go when they make an offer, take it over to another real estate professional, and they're presenting themselves as a bona fide offer that they can't deliver?
Well, here's the difference between typically Gold Star pre-approval letter, or in our case with the Fast Pass, an actual approval letter, is that we will do a follow-up phone call to the offer that's being made by our buyer's agent to the listing agent to assure them that this person is qualified.
That's a big issue right there, especially when you're dealing right now in three last numbers I saw for Southern California is about 3.9 months supply of inventory, and a normal market is 6 months supply of houses for sale. When you've got a lot of competition out there, what are you doing to differentiate yourself, right?
Exactly.
You got to come in there with something a little bit different. I know there's a lot of ads out there on the radio, and you can listen to, you know, you go to the big blue guys on with the big blue signs on the corner, every corner. And I can tell you this, my son worked at Bank of America for a while. And the progression was teller, personal banker, mortgage loan officer, right? And, you know, I love my son dearly, and he's been around this for a long time, but that doesn't mean that he was qualified to be helping somebody with a $600,000 transaction, right? There's a lot that goes into it, more than just getting that to the finish line.
Well, of course, that's the difference between an order taker and a true loan officer.
Now, the other part of it is that we also look at the concept. And I know your philosophy on this, Rick. One and done or lifelong relationship?
Of course. I mean, that we want to do their children's loans.
And that's you can't go in there and not deliver if your anticipation is get the kids' loans. You got to deliver from day one.
Absolutely. It's all about the customer experience.
So explain that a little bit, the customer experience. How do you differentiate in a customer experience? I mean, 'cause at the end of the day, we just want escrow to close.
Well, truly, we're a consultant more than we are anything. If you can acquire the documentation that you need and consult the client appropriately and in a meaningful manner and get your team to embrace that individual, then their experience throughout the period of closing is going to be much better.
I would suggest that in most instances, buying a house is very nerve-wracking for most people.
Especially the first time.
Right. Well, and we've seen some of the late numbers, the late statistics. It used to be that we bought a house every 6 years. Now we're up to every 10 years. So if you buy your first house at 30, you know, by the time you're 60, you've done this three times.
At least.
Right? And you're talking about doing it 8 times a month or 10 times a month. I guess it gives you a little more sense of security when you're giving somebody guidance. I've seen it before.
Well, of course. I mean, the bottom line is that you want to share your knowledge as a professional, no matter what it is. And we align ourselves with those individuals that can help our clients, such as talking about the title and escrow people. I mean, they're an intricate part of that, and they can make or break your deal. So
now let's ask about the other side of it, Rick, because so many people they'll go driving around the streets on the weekend. They look at open houses. They see a sign out there. They think that they're going to get a deal because they went to the listing agent, even though they're not paying anything for it anyway. But you shared earlier about the idea of coming to see you first and talk about getting totally underwritten. Can you then help somebody find a qualified real estate agent instead of just a bunch of signs out there?
Well, of course. I mean, with our company, we specifically align ourselves with the top agents in the area, and we'll align the client with that proper person, do the introductions, and make sure they're being taken care of.
Now, being that I kind of teased this a little bit earlier, and we'll have to throw this at Rick unannounced, because I didn't legitimately, Rick and I did not prep at all for the broadcast today, and then having some technical difficulties to start off. You know, we even had more fun with that. So I'm going to throw this at him real quick here. I've told you this before. I mean, being that we only have 7 listeners, Rick, would you mind waiving lender fees for our clients today?
Absolutely.
Okay. Good deal. So you heard it here. There's only seven of you, so you got to be one of the first ones to call. And I like to say it. I don't know how long we can get Rick to do this for, so make sure you're calling right away. Hopefully we can do it at least until the end of the month. We'll both just spend some of his money.
Isn't it only the 5th?
Yeah, it's the 5th. We can do that till the end of the month, right? Waive lender fees for anybody that mentions they heard you?
Of course.
Okay, so that's, you heard it here, just for seven of you, call today. Rick's going to waive the lender fees at Gold Star Mortgage when you get a loan through his team here. And give us a call and make sure to set that first radio preset button to come back here every day to join Ron Siegel Radio, where we only speak about items affecting your house and your bank account. Thanks to all of our sponsors. We text John today big time, but he's engineering us. And of course, a special thanks to you for spending a little bit of your day with us. That's all for Ron Siegel Radio. Again, if you have any questions or to meet or to meet any of our guests, call me anytime, 800-306-1990, 800-306-1990, or ronsiegelradio.com. And remember, make a lot of money, help a lot of people, have a lot of fun. Have a great day. We'll talk to you next time on Ron Siegel Radio.